We are going to try and help make sure that the survivors get what is their due. A lot of them want to be relocated, so I hope the government takes that into account. There is still a lot of work to be done here. But it's a huge tragedy. I'd like to thank all the people who are working here, the doctors, the nurses, the administration, volunteers. I'm very proud of everyone who's working here. But it's very, very sad to see. Well, let's see. I mean, to me, this is a national disaster for sure. But let us see. Let us see what the government says. Look, I don't think this is the place or the time to talk about political issues. People here require help. So I think the time right now is to make sure that all the assistance comes. There are people here who are in shock. They need medical assistance. So I think those are the things we should be discussing. Let me finish. I'm not interested in politics right now. I'm interested in the people of Wayanad. I'm interested in them getting the best possible care, best possible protection, and being looked after for the future. I feel how I had felt when my father died. That I've seen so many people. I remember what I felt when my father died. And here people have not just lost a father. They've lost the whole family. Entire family, brother, sister, mother, father. So I know what I felt. And this is much worse than that. And it's not one person who's feeling it. It's thousands of people who are feeling it. So it's very, very sad. And I think we all owe these people respect, affection, and we should all be standing with them. And I'm very proud that a lot of people are standing with the people of Wayanad. In fact, the whole nation's attention is towards Wayanad, and I'm sure that the whole nation is going to help the people of Wayanad. Thank you very much.
I feel very similar to what my brother feels. We have spent the whole day meeting people who have suffered. It's an immense tragedy. We've met a little boy who was holding on for 6 hours trying to save his mother, and he failed.
Not just his mother, his whole family.
His whole family. And he managed to save his grandmother, but he failed to save his mother. We can only imagine the kind of pain that people are suffering. And as my brother said, they've lost their entire families. So we are here to give as much comfort and support as we can, to help in any way we can. And I am also very proud to see how everybody is coming together, not just from Wayanad and from Kerala, but from the whole country, to help everybody who is going through this, do everything that we can to support our countrymen and those who are suffering. There's been a big tragedy in Himachal as well today. I think perhaps over 40 people have passed away there as well in a very similar situation. So our condolences and wishes for them also to get over this tragedy as best they can, and all our support and help to everybody. And I just have no words, actually.
Ma'am, there are so many kids. Excuse me. There are so many kids who lost their whole family. Do you have anything in mind
for them? So our state governments have also offered help. We are helping from here, and of course, the administration here is also doing all they can. And when we're here tomorrow, we are thinking of sitting down and just chatting out how many affected people there are, what all we can do, what help is coming, how much support is coming, and how we can assist, especially the children who are left on their own. I think one thing is very clear, that everybody who has been affected, who has been living in this area, most of them are saying that they don't want to go back and live in the same area, because it's not the first time it's happened there. So I think we'll have to think of some solution where they can be rehabilitated in a safer area.